Let's talk about a word that's maybe overused, goal setting. And I don't even care for the word necessarily because it sounds too formal, you know, like something you have to do. But really what I want to talk about maybe is either just visualization, maybe just believing in yourself, just writing some stuff down. You know, I think it's really important. I did that several years ago before I even had this studio. I had a little tiny studio, 300 square feet. Up by the penitentiary, yeah, nice location. Had great business going with you know, men in orange suits needing passport photos. I couldn't figure out what was going on, but it kept me going for a while. No, seriously, I had to back up through a door to take photographs to my camera room. I mean, it was really bad. I was working till 2 o'clock in the morning all the time. But I didn't believe that was always gonna be my life. Someone said, write it down what you want to do and what you want to be. So I did it. I wrote it down. I sat down with my wife and wrote down business, spiritual, family, personal stuff that we wanted to accomplish. Kind of forgot about it. And several years later, I looked back on that list and realized, you know, I had accomplished probably 80% of the things on that list I had already done without even thinking about it. But I believe that it would happen. I would do things like people would call up and say, hey, I'm interested in having a portrait taken in your studio of my child. Oh, I specialize in children and especially children's wall portraits, even when I hadn't even sold one yet. I was really not lying. I was basically just kind of telling the truth in advance of what I believe what would happen in my life, booking schedules back to back, even this little tiny studio. I wrote down sights, sounds, what I believe my studio would look like, colors, that I wanted to be an art gallery, feel to it. I mean, I wrote down every detail about what my business was going to look like, even when I was in a 300-foot square studio, because I knew my brain would figure out how to make it happen. Tony Robbins talks about it very, very eloquently. He says, you know, your brain is kind of like a computer. If you give it bad information or ask bad questions, it's going to come out with, you know, like a computer, if you ask it a question, it will give you the answer. So if you ask a bad question, like, why am I stupid at business? Why do I suck at photography? Your brain will say, well, you idiot, don't you know why? Don't you remember this, this, and this? And we'll come up with an idea. But if you ask your brain a good question, like, how can I be better? How can I have a better business? How can I have a studio that, you know, serves my family, but I can also have a life? You know, your brain will go out and research that for you, and it may not come immediately, but in time, those opportunities will present themselves to you. A class will come up, an opportunity, a friendship, whatever will happen because you're open to the idea. And so, you know, remember, good input in, good output, bad input, bad output. Really just believe, trust, even write some things down, but don't obsess over it, you know. But I think it can happen in your life. It certainly has happened for me. So I just wanted to share that with you.